Creed has always intrigued me because it has all of the characteristics of an island. You know, it's completely independent. It's surrounded by the sea, which makes access to it somewhat difficult. At the same time, however, it's also a crossroads, so you get many people coming into the island.
Etzrayim is an ecumenical place, and it's open to everyone. So Nikos also calls it, it's basically the Brotherhood of Abraham, so everybody who shares in the values of openness and tolerance is welcome here. And so on Friday nights when we have prayers here, you find people of every background, Jews and non-Jews, Christians, Catholics, Protestants, Orthodox, or even atheists. This openness is mainly due to Nikos, who defined the place from its very beginning as such an open space.
Our community, I call it a Havura, a kind of brotherhood, and that grew up quite automatically after I had finished the building. A number of Muslims began coming to morning prayers, and a number of Greek Orthodox, and a number of non-believers, and a number of non-allied people whatsoever, who had no interest in religion whatsoever, but were intrigued by the Jewish presence in Crete. I've had to make sure that the synagogue be a synagogue, you know, but it's potentially open to anyone who wants to pray in there.
These were put here by Nikos, and he explained that it's originally it's a Buddhist tradition, but apparently also a Jewish tradition in Anatolia, that if you pick pieces of cloth of a specific person and you put it up on a tree, you can actually make a wish for that person. So it's a probably some kind of popular tradition somewhere in Anatolia, and Nikos introduced it here because we have like all kinds of traditions here. People started coming in, writing little prayers or wishes on sheets of paper, and then stuffed them in the wood carvings all around the Torah shrine. And of course, that's reminiscent of the Kotel, of the Wailing Wall in Jerusalem.
I have to keep a certain kind of authenticity to this place. I mean, it's a Jewish synagogue. You know, it's not a syncretic synagogue, you know, where there's a corner for Muslims to pray, a corner for Christians to pray, a corner for Jews to pray. It's what it is. Oh, and I'm very proud of that. I think it's probably the only synagogue in the whole of Europe, you know, that has its doors wide open. You know, there's no policeman there, there's no guard there, there's no one to check what you come in with. You know, it's a free, open space, and God willing, it will keep that way. Welcome you in the name of our community, which is rather strange community. prayers go straight up to heaven. One's prayers are pure in that building simply because they're not wrapped up with religious politics, you know, and with antagonisms that grow out of religious schisms.